Welcome to a lesson on function notation. Now that we know a function is a special relation in which each input has exactly one output, we often use special notation to communicate that a relation is a function. The notation is called function notation. For example, here we see y equals f of x. So f of x is function notation, where f of x is the output resulting from applying the function rule f to the input x. So when using function notation, we need to remember that x is the input and f of x is the output, and therefore f of x is equal to y. When we first see this notation though, it's easy to think that this means f times x, but it does not. It's special notation called function notation. As an example, if we were given the function f of x equals 2x plus 3, the first thing we should recognize is that this is equivalent to the equation y equals 2x plus 3. But we use this special notation, function notation, to indicate that this equation does represent a function. To find a function value, for example, let's say f of 4, we substitute 4 for x. So f of 4 is equal to 2 times 4 instead of 2 times x, and then plus 3. Well, 2 times 4 is 8, so this is equal to 8 plus 3, which is equal to 11. So we say f of 4 equals 11. But we should also recognize this represents a point on the graph of our function, where the x-coordinate is 4 and the y-coordinate is 11. So when we find function values, notice how we're finding y values. Let's take a look at several more examples. Here we're given f of x and asked to find f of 4 and f of negative 3. So this really comes down to substituting 4 for x and then negative 3 for x. So f of 4 would be equal to, instead of x squared, we'd have 4 squared. Instead of minus 5 times x, we'll have minus 5 times 4, and then plus 6. And now we simplify this following the order of operations. So we'd first square 4, that's 16, and then minus 5 times 4, that'd be minus 20, plus 6. So this would be 16 minus 20 is negative 4, plus 6 is positive 2. So we can say f of 4 equals positive 2, which again would represent the point 4, 2 on the graph of this given function. For f of negative 3, we'll now substitute negative 3 for x. So we'd have negative 3 squared minus 5 times negative 3 plus 6. It is important that we include parentheses around this negative 3. X squared means x times x. So for negative 3 squared, we do need negative 3 times negative 3, which would be positive 9. So we'd have positive 9. Here we have negative 5 times negative 3, that's plus 15, and then plus 6. So this would be 9 plus 15, that's 24, plus 6 is 30. So we would say f of negative 3 equals 30. Let's take a look at two more examples. Notice in this example, our function is g of t. So the input is t and the output is g of t. So to find g of negative 3, we'll substitute negative 3 for t. But we need to be careful when performing this substitution. We can think of this as the opposite of t squared. So if we substitute negative 3 for t, we would have negative and then negative 3 squared plus 2 times negative 3 minus 12. So when we begin to simplify here, negative 3 squared is positive 9, but then we have a negative sign here, so that is going to be negative 9. Then we have plus 2 times negative 3, that's plus negative 6, or just minus 6, minus 12. This would be negative 15 minus 12, that's negative 27. So g of negative 3 equals negative 27. So when we have an input of t equals negative 3, our function value or output is negative 27. Notice in our next example, the input is a variable expression, 3x, which means g of 3x will not give us a real value it'll give us another function. But the process is the same. We're going to substitute 3x for t. So we'll have negative and then 3x squared plus 2 times 3x minus 12. Well, 3x squared would be 9x squared. Then we want the negative of that, or the opposite of that. So we'll have negative 9x squared. This will be plus 6x, and then minus 12. We can't combine any of these terms because they're not like terms, so we're actually done. G of 3x is equal to negative 9x squared plus 6x minus 12. Let's go ahead and take a look at one more example. Here we're given the function h of y equals 2y squared minus y plus 7, and we're asked to find h of the quantity m minus 2. So in this case, we'll substitute the quantity m minus 2 for y. So this would give us 2 times the quantity m minus 2 squared minus the quantity m minus 2 plus 7. First, we need to simplify the exponents. So we'll have to multiply m minus 2 by itself. That would give us 2 times m minus 2 times m minus 2. Let's go ahead and multiply this out first. We'll have 4 products, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So we'll have 2 times the quantity m times m is m squared. And then we have m times negative 2, that's negative 2m. And then we have negative 2 times m, that's another negative 2m. So minus 4m, negative 2 times negative 2 is plus 4. Now we'll clear the parentheses. Here we'll distribute 2. And because of the minus sign here, we can think of distributing a negative 1. So we would have 2m squared minus 8m plus 8. And then we'd have minus m plus 2. And plus 7. The last step will combine like terms. There's only one m squared term. There are two m terms. Negative 8m minus 1m is negative 9m, or minus 9m. And then we have 8 plus 2 plus 7, which is 17. So we found that h of m minus 2 is equal to 2m squared minus 9m plus 17. I hope you found this helpful.